Hey up everybody, Vox Esto here, and tonight we're on the center for another sneaky low profile build. It's going to be awesome this time. We're going to build a little bit bigger so you can fit more tribey stuff in here, maybe a dino. Yeah, hit that like button, subscribe if you're new to the channel, get stuck in. Let's get stuck in. Right, I don't know why I said stuck in twice. We're getting well stuck. Right, we're at 28.5.04 this time. And it's not as hidden, but it's right on the edge, look. Oh, look at that. Oh, right up there. Now, this spot is like proper pucker. There's some nice, proper flat land up here. You got some metal here. Look, let me run you around. So, all this flat land, but we're going to build right over there in the corner. This bit over here, we're going to keep away from it because that's our metal spawn. Got a little bit of oil down there and a nice ramp going up. You're going to have a little dip. Wet the old knees and all that. Got a tree. Right, so yeah. Don't know why I'm showing you the chords again, just in case you didn't see it the first time, all that sort of stuff. So banging on with it, we've got a foundation, woo! And here comes some more. Right, so we're going to go 4x4. So let's slap all these down. And I mean, obviously, if you're on a server that has a lot of hassle, and there's a lot of big tribes, double foundation it, triple foundation it, do as you please. But for this guard, I'm just going to be doing one because it's a bit quicker. You all know how to do two foundations and stuff like that, you don't need showing. Right, now I'm also going to pop some ceilings around the outside so we can get extra walls in. Oh, it looks like I need to get rid of this metal, let me skip it. Look at that, nice and quick, let's get rid of it. God, if only gathering was like that normally, it'd be mental. Get so much done so quickly. Right, so we're not going to do the cliff side because it's obviously, we've got a cliff there. It's not going to touch it, but you'll see what I mean. It's not really too desperate. So we're going to go with the fence foundations. Drop them all in around the outside. Well, around the inside, I guess. Look, I'm going to keep you with me for this one because it's like tricksy stuff, isn't it? Look at that, look. Scroll through them snap points. There's millions. I wish there was like an easier, well, there is easier ways. They're called mods. Mods are for shards. We're not doing it. This is vanilla stuff. All right, I'll stop rambling on in a minute. When this is done, obviously. All right, so we're gonna put these in. We're probably gonna get rid of them first two later on, but I wanna show you with them in. All right, and then just pop the other ones in there. Oh, well, that's gone a bit funky, hasn't it? Don't want that. Right, there you go. Now this is why we have the ceilings round the outside, because then we're going to get these extra foundations in and that will give us four walls thick on the outside. And that's what we want. We want max protection, guys. We don't want people just like quickly popping a wall off and getting to all our goodies. We want to be locked down nice and tight when we go to bed, beddy buyers at night. Right, so, wow, that was annoying. I don't know where that even ended up. Somewhere. Alright. So that. Right, perfect. Oh, it's first time. Oh no, he's ruined it. He got too cocky, didn't he? There you go. Obviously take your time when you do this in the real world, because you're just gonna waste so many materials. I mean, I can waste as much as I want, but it don't matter. So we'll get these last couple in. And the last one, first time. Oh, you honestly? Right, there it is. Right, cool. Now, what I done was I got rid of the ceilings. Don't get rid of the ceilings because you need them for a snap point. So keep ceilings on. And then, obviously, you can see you get four walls there. So place one. Remember that Q button? Two. Three. Look, oh, really? Right, no. even though you can talk, there it is. Even though you can talk through, it's still annoying. Look how thick that is. That's the thickest thing I've ever seen. Well, it's probably not. I've seen loads thicker than that, but. Well, that's four thick. That is four walls thick. Then I'm going to have to place another ceiling so I can do these ones. And then we're going to do exactly the same here, but we're going to use door frames. So let's slap all them in. I'm not going to be doing this whole build like this, guys, because it just wastes time. I'll probably just do like the walls one layer thick, just to show you like the general gist of the base, if you know what I mean. Right, and get rid of these as well, because you don't want them, because that'll stop you going through the door easily. Get rid of ceiling, there you go, and they all stick together all nice and super glued. Right, now for the foundations at the bottom, we want to just put some ramps in, so we've got some extra protection. I mean, if you had ramps and two or three foundations thick, you'd be laughing. You'd have lots of protection. Right, so for this bit, I'll just put a ramp there as well. Obviously, ramps all the way around. Now we want to get a pillar in here. There are multiple ways to do this, but this is the way I'll do it. What's that? Oh, okay, so this is going to be really difficult here, because for some reason this fence foundation goes into the floor like an idiot. Right, so you're just going to have to guess it like that. And that was wrong, so don't rush it. Right, okay, let's do that again. Look, I can't even see it. Demolish the floor. No. Okay. All right, take your time, buddy. Take your time. Oh, I wish it would just poke out. If you're on, like, a normal surface, that would just poke out and you'll be able to see exactly where you're placing it. But I'm going to say... what do you reckon? About there? About there. That's perfect. I bet that's perfect. That'll do. That'll do the job. Then, obviously, with that, you can go up and down and stuff like that. And, you know, you can go all the way to the top if you want, but you don't really need to. Just do the bottom one. That'll just protect the corner for you. And then that's all good. So do that on the other corner. And then obviously walls, four walls all the way around the outside bar one bit. And I'll show you that bit in a second. But that's what we're going to be doing all the way up. I'm not going to do it in this video though, because that would just take me forever. So I'm just going to like that. I'm just going to pop them up one layer thick, because you know how it goes. You don't need to see it. Look at that beauty. Right, so what I was going to say was, these two here, leave a gap here, because that's where we're going to be putting the old dino gates. So with all the walls in, I've gone for door frames on the third level, because that's where our turrets are going to be. I mean, you don't have to do door frames. You can make it hard on yourself to refill them and stuff, but we've just put them in just as a guide. Right, so this is what I don't want to do. Yes, I can snap the gate to that, and that looks all nice and neat, exactly where you want it. Let's get this level, and I'll show you why I don't want it. Because now, when I go to snap, get this close, it won't let me. Because them foundations are too close. So what you do is, you just get rid of that and that, and then that, you know, it's going to ruin that gate, but don't worry about the gate, I've got plenty more. So drop a gate in without them fence foundations there. You can push it out a bit further as well. It's up to you how far out you want it. Let's get this all nice and lined up. Obviously, with all these four walls thick, you know, you've got loads of playroom, so there ain't no gaps. Because you don't want gaps. Look at that. Pop that in. And then, as you can see, I still get that little snap, but if I just edge to the side, lets me go a little bit closer every time. So just edge to the side until you're as close as you want. Like, there's pretty nice. That's pretty nice right there. I like that. Yeah, that's how you double gate. So there you go, we've got two gates. That's kind of our weak spot, but that ain't a thing. That ain't even a thing to worry about. Don't worry about that, because you understand why. It's not going to be a hollow shell. This ain't no hollow shell. It's going to be built up on the inside. Right, so now you've got your gate and all your walls, you want to segregate this corner as a 2x2 foundation, just like that. And then obviously you can put more fence foundations in if you're really paranoid. You can have four walls thick absolutely everywhere inside this base. Now this bit, we want to go around the outside like so, Like that, can you see what's going on there? We've got three foundations in the middle. Yeah, you got the picture? Right, three foundations in the middle is going to be where we're putting our stuff. Everything else on the outside is just there because. Just because. Right, so some of these things, what you're going to be better off dropping in before you put your walls in. So let's put our fabricator at the bottom. Can't really see because of the glare on them. That's a bit annoying. So we want to fabricate here. And guys, everyone has their own personal preference on where to place things. So you don't have to put everything exactly how I've put it in this one, because, you know, you might find a better way to put it in. That's up to you to decide. You know, it's going to be your base at the end of the day, so do it however you want. Then we just pop two doors in there. Pop that open, pop that in, and that's how we're going to access our fabricator. And then this little square here is going to be for the generator. Yeah, let's put walls in first so we know what we're going against. And obviously there's multiple snap points here as well, so you can go to, the way I've done it, this is going to be two thick. Well, you could do three thick, but you could do four, like the outside, but I mean, you don't have to overkill it on the inside. It's up to you. It's up to you how you do it. And then that bit there as well. Right, so dropping in the Jenny. Dropping in the Jenny. She wants to go about there. Yeah, that looks good to me. Snug as a bug in a rug. Then we just drop the old door frames in. Where do I want it? I want it on that. Alright, that's it, cool. Yeah. I mean, obviously you can, once again, you can put more than one door in there. I'm just trying to speed things up for you a bit, really. We're still making an okay video. So like all these, look, you'll see there's gaps there, but that's, you can close that with just putting in all your layers of walls. They'll close off the gaps for you. Nice and simply done. And then we've got some more. Right, so this is going to be where we keep our flyer. So why not just keep the forges here as well? I mean, it's not really a problem, is it? If someone comes, breaks in through that door and demolishes our forges, then fair enough. And then we want the old grill. Can't beat having a grill. It's not something, you know, you need to worry about too much. You're not going to have anything worth stealing on it. Forges, if you log out burning stuff, then yeah, fair dues, but you know, you'll only lose a bit of metal. You can go pick up some more. We'll use them as like a jumping puzzle as well. Alright, so up here, let's slap some ceilings down. Try and do it too thick on every layer. Do it as thick as you do the walls. If you do your walls four thick, do your ceilings four thick. If you do them too thick, do, you know, you know where I'm going with it. You don't need that explaining. Right, so we'll grab some more walls. Come back round here. Got to do this jump puzzle every time. I mean, you don't have to do the outside walls first. You could do them last and it'd probably make it easier to get in and around things. Right. So, what else are we going to put up here? I'm thinking smithy. If you think that's a good idea, put smithy here. Whoops, forgot that was a door. What a twonk. See, I think a smithy's good here. I like it. I mean, you could put what you want on this level, as long as it fits and you don't get yourself stuck. Think about it logically. Look, there you go. It's always better to place a smithy before you place your walls as well, because you can place a smithy a bit more tightly into a corner, whereas if your walls are down already, it'll say, nah mate, there's like a wall in my way, even though it's not even anywhere near touching it. So yeah, that looks pretty good. I mean, we'll pop another door frame in to just snug that hole off, because it looks messy. But obviously, like I said before, I'm just getting it done. There you go. Lovely job. absolutely lovely job. That door will probably help us getting in this room as well. Look at that, it did. Right, so, other things up here. Let's put a couple of beds on this level. Because it's quite a good level to be on for a bed. I mean, you can put a bed on every level if you want, because they're easy to just place. You can just put them anywhere. It'd probably be best to put one on every level, because then you've got multiple spawn points if you need to quickly grab your stuff while you're getting raided and leave the base a different way. So here we go with some mortar and pestles. We can get 4 in here. You can put more than that in. I'm just going to use 4 because that's the sort of guy I am. I don't know what that means. I'm a 4-shotter guy. Right, so we want a hatch frame there. We'll slap a ceiling. We'll slap another ceiling. Double layer, triple layer, quad layer, as you see fit. So we'll take a wooden ladder and use that. Always use wooden ladders inside your base, people, because then when people try and blow walls up and stuff, they end up ruining the ladders. Stops them climbing about where they shouldn't be. So this one, we're just going to pop walls all the way around. Like before, there's a gap there. Obviously, you're not going to see these gaps because you're going to be building it properly and sticking to your too thick policy throughout the inside of the base or whatever you choose. So what shall we put on this level? We could put a fridge. Fridge would look good. I mean, it's pretty tight in here, guys, but you know, you don't need to swing a, I don't know, ankle low in here. You don't need all that room. You gotta keep nice and tight, nice and well protected. Look at that, snug. Love it, that's my word of the day, snug. This is a snug base. Right, let's see if we can get the cooking pot in. Get it as close to that wall as possible. There you have it. Stupid snap points, crazy. Right, okay. And then we want a feeding trough, just so we've got one in the base. Helps spoil meat. You can just fill it up with meat, it'll spoil. And it'll feed your tame what you got in the old pen. So yeah, let's get some, see, we'll have another hatch frame there. And then the ceilings. It's getting tight up here, isn't it? Gosh, here it's getting tight. I love it. Right, we'll continue the ladder same way up. So if you're in a hurry, you can just go straight up. Alright, we need to get some more stuff. Let's close that. And close that. That'll look better later. Right, okay, so I've got on top. And yeah, there's the ceiling. Now on this level, we're going to just place some doors around and stuff. Oh, that didn't fit. I'll move that in a minute. So top tip, don't put your fridge too close to the wall. Right, what I'm thinking is, we will just go with a ramp, which to be fair, I'm going to place it metal. You could just place it as like a thatch one, thatch ceiling, or say a wooden ramp would do it. If you'd done the slopey thatch ceiling, it'd probably be better because it blow up quicker, thus giving them less ways of getting in. Excuse me. And then we're gonna go with some catwalks. This is gonna be where our turrets are, so you've got access to refill your turrets when you need to. Can we place them from out here? That'd be handy, wouldn't it? Go on. Go on. Go on. Oh, Bezler. Right, so if you wanted to, you could just skip and hop across them to fill them up. If you do that, you wouldn't have to use door frames all the way around, so that'd be cool. Or, you know, it wouldn't be cool. I don't know. Do it however you prefer it, really. I'm just going to plop another ramp in here. If it'll let me, of course. There you go, nice. And another catwalk. Lovely. Right, I could probably just place them from up here, to be honest. I don't have to mess about too much. Look at that, it's so much easier. You just stand up here. Lush. All the way around. Can I, oh, I can just jump down and do that. Oh, I'm stuck. I'm stuck. Someone help. Someone. Right, okay, so we've got all them done. We're going to put doors in there so we can get to them ramps. And then we're just going to box round. It's all nice. Now, I've got this suicide door here going into our, like, bit down the bottom. Just as an extra route out. So now we need to seal in up. Just like that. And this is the top layer, people. I mean, you can put what you want up here. I don't think I need to put anything else down, so... You know, you could put another smithy up here if you really wanted to. If you want to squeeze one in, that's up to you. Or just like spawn beds, because it's a high point. But this, remember, above me is going to be the roof itself. So the less you have up here, the better, really. But obviously, you can use all these as multiple ways out of your base when you're getting raided. And then having that suicide door going into the little dino pen bit makes it super handy, because you can get your stuff, jump down onto your flyer, straight out them doors. Right, so, what's next? Ceilings, look. Obviously, your top layer, definitely 4 ceilings thick, because your outer wall is 4 thick, so do your ceilings 4 thick on the top. You could even get away with some more there, look, because we've got extra snap points. Bolster up that middle bit nicely. And then just whack them around all over. Make it all nice and snug and neat. God, I can't stop saying snug today. It's like such a good word. I think I said lush a couple of times as well. And that was lush and stuff. Right, so... Where else could we put something? I think that's alright, actually. Ah, I know what we could do. We could have another suicide door up here. What I'm thinking, if we plop that there, then we could get a wooden ladder on this wall here. Yeah, look at that. Another quick access to the top. Obviously, a raider ain't going to be able to use that because they'll just smash the ladder. And then you got all your layers, everything's in here you need. Oh, it's all nice, isn't it? It's well protected as well. Right, guys, so I've got all the turrets and that in, got it all sorted out. If you want to come have a look, let's go see. Let's have a little fly from a bit further away. As you can see, I've put turrets on all the sticky outy bitch, a couple on the top, and then I've put some plant X's either side. Nice sectioned off 9 plant X turrets up the top as well. So that should do you good. And then obviously getting into the base, down here, look, open both your doors. You just fly straight in. Just crawl in, just jump off. Close your doors. I know exactly what's happening here, I'm gonna get stuck, ain't I? Yeah, okay. So think about it a bit more. There'll be a way to jump off this and everything will just work. Ah, there you go. Alright, so let's have a little look now, everything's in. As you can see, the cables have just come straight up from the Jenny. Put some cross ones in. The mortars, it's all nice. Look at that, ladder up here. Obviously, you can have more than one hatch frame there. You can have like 2. Or 4 max. Got a lot of stuff there, it's all nice. Open that one up. And then this is the top layer. Completely empty. Put what you want up here, don't really matter. And then you got access to the turrets. It's all nice, look. Have a look out there. Let's go back in. Obviously, you can use that as like drop down, extra route out. Look, quick route to your Jenny. There's your fabricator tucked away at the bottom as well. Then you've got some space there. You can put stuff out here as well if you want. And there we go, look. Just come through there. Oh, I like it. Then you've got a little suicide door up there, quick access to the top layer. It's all nice. Then another escape route out there, quick access to your flyer if you need it, or just to shoot down at people who've just got through your door. You never know what's going to happen. You never know. So that's pretty much it, guys. I mean, it's all nice and good. It's nicely protected. You got everything you need. You ain't like massively out, well, you are out in the open because like there's nothing covering you, but you know, you're on the edge of the map. The only other thing I want to show you is a little trick. So let's say you're getting raided, you get out of your base and you're like, oh nah, oh quick, have a look, oh use your last rocket, just throw it that way. Oh right, let's go just drop some stuff off in our secret stash and maybe pick up another couple of things. So we just head straight down this waterfall down here, look, and there you go, we've got a vault here waiting for us. Get the last supplies we need, or drop some supplies off if they ain't seen you go this way. Hadn't even placed a bed here. Look, you could just pop a bed down. There, that's perfect. Proper sly little hole. Look at that. That's all you need, isn't it? I mean, you can dot these all over the cliff. People will be well wound up with you. And that's pretty much it for this guide, people. I mean, it's a super sweet spot. You can't beat that. There's ledges everywhere around here, but this is like perfect. You got metal spawns and everything. You can't beat it. You just can't beat it. What do you reckon? So if you like the video, guys, don't forget to hit that thumbs up button and subscribe if you're new to the channel, people, and we will see you soon. Take it easy.